ARPA-E plays an important role in the U.S. energy innovation ecosystem.
We're all here to solve the three problems that Congress told us to solve: weaning ourselves off of foreign energy sources, increasing energy efficiency in the U.S., and it's reducing emissions related to energy use.
When we talk about changing what's possible, it's not just the technologies. It's actually the approach to research, and it's the approach to engaging the broad energy community in moving things from ARPA-E onto the next part of the development cycle of energy technologies.
We're investing in the best people, the best small companies, and the best ideas to bring entirely new energy technologies to market.
The best thing that we can have is a suite of different options, because it's risky and it's hard, and we're not foolish enough to think that we can prescribe the solution up front.
Our role as ARPA-E is to fund early stage technology development before the private sector is willing to get involved. We're trying to remove enough of the technical risk that the private sector and industry can pick it up and run with it.
ARPA-E is not about just identifying some big new problem. I think the problems in energy are pretty well known. ARPA-E's unique piece of this is framing the problem in a way that it has not been framed before. And therefore you bring different people to the table with different eyes on the solution.
You're trying to engage people that are really brilliant, pushing them to get off their comfort zone and really thinking about the problems in a very innovative way. It's something that is very distinctive of us as an agency.
We're asking them to cross disciplinary boundaries to really come up with new approaches to difficult problems in energy.
We would run into folks who would stop us and say, you know, I've been working on this field of chemistry for 20 years, and I never knew that my work could be so important for the energy problem.
We actually go on site with all of our performers multiple times a year. And we spend a substantial amount of time with the research teams trying to brainstorm with them how they might solve their problem. It's a real true partnership.
That all start out with you and your team, but it goes beyond that.
We ask questions like, let's say you're wildly successful, how much could you imagine this technology costing? How cheap could it be? Is it going to be good enough to actually move the needle based on what we have? And we look at each part of the life cycle through the lens of, if it works, will it matter?
Just because some of them will likely not be successful doesn't mean it's not worth going for it. And a lot of those things that, you know, might not be the home run still teach us a lot about how to ask the next question.
I think the impact that we make as an agency goes way beyond developing technologies and commercializing them, but also educating and developing a community that can be leveraged again and again.
Our success really depends on engaging the broad community in what's possible and having them believe that it's plausible that this can move all the way to the market and change things for future generations.